Hello and welcome back to the acne series. This video is part one of putting it all together. I assume you've been good little instruction followers and watched the previous acne series videos in their intended succession. If you haven't, I highly recommend going back and starting from the beginning so you can fully understand the guidelines that I'm about to put down. Clear skin starts from the inside. Following here is my formula for getting rid of chronic acne for good. First and foremost, food is the most intimate way we interact with our environment. What you choose is explicitly and irrevocably essential to the health of your skin and your entire body. The dietary guidelines I recommend are as follows. Low fat, first and foremost. A low-fat diet is essential. When you're first getting started, consider keeping an online food journal through a program like Chronometer and get an idea of just how much fat you're actually eating. Many people on a standard Western diet eat around 40% or more of their calories from fat. And that number should actually be under 15%, with some people doing even better, around 10% of their calories coming from fat. As an example, this means that a person who eats about 2,000 calories per day, which is the minimum we should be shooting for, would eat around 200 calories of fat, which would equate to about 22 grams of fat per day. The source of that fat matters. There are such things as essential fatty acids, and it's important that we acquire enough of those essential fatty acids and their precursors. We find healthy fats like these in foods like small amounts of fresh, unroasted nuts and seeds, especially flax, pumpkin, sesame, walnuts, and almonds, avocados, whole grains, legumes, dark leafy greens, and in smaller amounts, fatty acids are found in virtually all fruits and vegetables. Eating moderate and varied amounts of these types of foods will easily give us enough dietary fat from good sources without consuming too much. High-fat foods, especially foods that contain saturated or trans fatty acids, are not only non-essential, they are actually detrimental to the health of our skin and our health as a whole. Foods that are high in these types of fats include all animal foods and most processed foods. There's also the case of added oils. Many foods come loaded with oil, and some of those oils are even touted as health foods, like olive and coconut oils. But for the sake of absolute clarity and understanding, no amount of any refined oil of any kind is a health food. They are empty calories, and empty calories coming from fat has serious consequences for arterial, liver, kidney, hormone, and skin health. Alright, so step one, low fat. In a similar trend as dietary fat, excess dietary protein is hard on our detoxification system, namely the kidneys. Just like fat, we should aim to keep our dietary protein intake to well below 15% of our daily calories, though below 10% is considered best and perfectly healthy. The easiest and most effective way to do this is by eating whole plant foods without purposely consuming refined high protein foods like protein powders. I repeat, do not have to worry about protein deficiency, ever. It doesn't exist, and it is not possible as long as you're eating sufficient calories. So don't stress, don't force yourself to eat ridiculous amounts of beans. Beans are wonderful for you and should definitely be a part of a healthy diet, but no force feeding of tofu or legumes, okay? Okay, this is a low stress diet. So this might leave you thinking, well, what the hell am I gonna eat? Carbohydrate-rich whole plant foods. So carbs are your fuel. They are incredibly important. So let's go through some example foods to determine what actually constitutes a high-carb food. Pizza is actually high in protein and fat and refined carbs. Donuts are a high-fat food. Spaghetti bolognese is a high-fat and high-protein food. Spaghetti with oil-free marinara with lentil meatballs is high-carb food. Fruit is high-carb. Whole grains, beans, legumes, potatoes, sweet potatoes, pumpkin. All of those are clean, balanced sources of carbohydrates, nutrients, and fiber, which brings us to the last two dietary guidelines. Nutrient-dense foods are those that are high in essential nutrition, like antioxidant active vitamins and minerals, while being relatively low in calories. This densely packed nutrition will allow your body to perform all the necessary functions like daily detoxification, effective repair of tissues, and balanced hormone production. High antioxidant foods protect your cells, including your skin cells, from damage and inflammation caused by free radicals. The most nutrient and antioxidant dense foods are plant foods, with special props going to colorful fresh fruits and vegetables. But I know what you're thinking. I'll just eat whatever and take a multivitamin. Wish it were that easy, but unfortunately the benefits of eating nutrients found in whole plant foods do not translate to taking isolated nutrient supplements. Nature, in all of her brilliant complexity, is much too intricate to be easily faked out. Don't waste your money or take risks with your health on unnecessary multivitamin supplements. Eat real food and enough of it. In addition to being nutrient dense, you're gonna wanna find fiber dense foods as well. So fiber is nature's great binder and regulator. It helps your body move out all the shit that doesn't need to be stuck inside you anymore. And I say that creepy on purpose because having 5 days worth of meals putrefying in your colon is creepy. Fiber. Especially the kind of fiber that's found in foods like sweet potatoes, bananas, Jerusalem artichokes, and beans, is the favorite type of food of beneficial gut bacteria. Eat up so that the writhing bacterial mass lining your intestines can be healthy, which makes you healthy. So, basically, eat whole plant foods to your heart's content. Or, more accurately, your stomach's content, which will produce healthy insides and reflect as healthy outsides. And I do want to say a quick word about food sensitivities causing acne. A lot of people experience breakouts when they eat a certain food, and the trigger food can be different for different people. Like for me, if I eat wheat, there's something in it, probably the gluten, that causes me to break out significantly along my jawline. I also have like a soy/tofu sensitivity. It's a real drag. Some of the most common trigger foods for causing acne are dairy, gluten, soy, white potatoes, bananas, coffee, eggs. If you're dealing with persistent acne around your mouth and jaw and you've cut out most of the high fat and high protein junk foods, there's a good chance you could be dealing with a food sensitivity. Eliminating the suspect foods for, unfortunately, several months, followed by a sudden isolated reintroduction, can give you a better clue as to which foods you need to avoid. Do note, though, that unfortunately it can take a long ass time before the breakouts caused by trigger foods can clear up. I told you, it's a pain in the ass. So the next guideline for healthy, glowing, clear skin is hydration. Drink plenty of clean water to keep your blood and lymph thin, fluid, and always pumping. Never stagnant. Help out your kidneys by giving them plenty of fluid to flush through your urinary system, ridding yourself of toxins, excess sodium, and regularly flushing out bacteria buildup. Help your liver out by preventing large amounts of water from having to be reabsorbed from your large intestine. Because if you're not drinking plenty of water through your mouth, your body will drink its own colon poo water. Preventing such disgusting reabsorption will also help your intestinal health by allowing you to have the shortest bowel transit time and easiest bowel movements you can healthfully and naturally achieve. I like filtered tap water or reverse osmosis water with 2 to 3 mineral drops added per liter. I buy commercially available mineral drops from my local health food store or Amazon, and one bottle generally lasts me like 2 to 3 years. I choose not to drink out of plastic bottles to avoid exposure to hormone disruptive chemicals found in plastics. I prefer drinking my 64 to 100 ounces of water per day out of stainless steel or glass containers. Next guideline for resolving chronic acne is sleep. Our bodies heal when we sleep. Sleep is absolutely vital for hormone regulation, controlling body-wide inflammation, managing food cravings, and so much more. We cannot skimp on our sleep and get away with it. So 8 to 10 hours a night, maybe more, is the ideal. If you can't manage the ideal, do your best to get as close as you can. And please, don't get pissed at me, because what your body actually needs to be healthy is almost impossible to achieve in this godforsaken 24-hour-a-day stimulation society that is killing us physically and emotionally. Next up is exercise. Breaking a sweat helps our body flush out toxicity, especially through the skin. It also rapidly increases body-wide blood flow, delivering oxygen and nutrient-rich blood to your skin and helping to flush out metabolic wastes that don't need to be in your cells anymore. Exercise is also the primary pump of your lymphatic system, the importance of which should not be underestimated. Moving around also helps digestive transit efficiency, balances stress hormones, and can lead to decreases in body-wide inflammation. Exercise has also been shown to increase our absorption of anti-inflammatory flavonoids and other beneficial compounds found in delicious whole plant foods that we eat. And working out even seems to have a positive effect on the diversity and health of our gut microbiome. However, the benefits of exercise quickly disappear if we force ourselves into exhausting workouts. Those kinds of activities lead to an increase in DNA damage, inflammation, and a decrease in gut health. So work out smart, listen to your body, and don't make yourself run until you puke. Next up is sunshine. Despite the violent demonization of sun exposure, our bodies evolved in the sun. Sunlight exposure to our skin is an important aspect of hormonal health and should not be ignored. Also, UV light is mildly antibacterial, and a little dosed to acne-prone areas can definitely assist your immune system in infection control. And since UV light is capable of penetrating your skin up to 1.5 inches, it can help to cleanse your lymph fluid and lymph nodes as well. Vitamin D, which is produced in our skin when we're exposed to UVB light, is also an integral part of overall health and inflammation management. So get a little bit of sun exposure. Just don't cover yourself in unnatural oils, including coconut oil or chemicalized sunscreen, and be mindful about when and how long you're exposed. Laying out for 3 hours during midday is foolish. Getting 20 minutes or half an hour during the less intense times of the day, say from like 9 to 11 a.m., is smart. Another practice that can help improve skin health and eventually eliminate acne breakouts is dry brushing. This can be difficult if you're dealing with really severe weeping breakouts. If that's the case, I recommend switching up your diet and lifestyle first, getting that under control, and then trying the dry brushing. So basically, dry brushing is exactly what it sounds like. You use a dry, vegan-bristled, softish skin brush on dry skin. I have a video about it, you can watch it here. Basically, it moves the lymph, it exfoliates the skin, and it feels incredible. And if you think positively intentioned thoughts about your skin and body while you do it, it's even more beneficial. So those are the first few fundamentals. I'll be covering the rest of my tips in part 2, which will include recommended supplements, herbal options, topical treatments, and more. So I'll see you shortly for part 2.